Adebayo Bolaji. Welcome and thank you very much for being part of this exhibition.
Thank you for having me.
And during the last 2 weeks, you have been extremely productive. You've made some, I don't know, maybe 20 works?
20
brand new paintings.
That's right.
It's incredible, incredible.
Thank you.
And one of the highlights is Bernadette, just behind us. Could you guide us through a little bit from the left, maybe to the right, and of course the centered female view?
Yes, I can, where you can see the the subject matter, the protagonist, if you will, is a very vibrant, confident woman. The name Bernadette actually means brave as a bear. And initially I didn't know that I wanted to paint a female, a woman, but I normally start with layering colors down and allow colors to lead me as to where I might feel and what the story or the narrative of the piece would be. And the technique I use with this piece, I normally use really passionate, aggressive, free flow sort of brush. This time I used a brush and a cloth as well to give a sort of sensual motion and feel, which I use with the red.
Absolutely, you can see it through the thickness of the paint and how it actually is being layered.
Yeah, that's right. And that in turn kind of led me towards a particular image in my head, and for some reason I was playing with the idea of this figure, particularly a woman, came to mind who is not ashamed of her being or sort of afraid to express herself, but is very confident. And obviously today there's the constant discussion, you know, about female body and feminism, etc., and how a woman is to present her body. But here is a figure who, despite what anyone feels, she's not being too forward, and neither is she too sort of introverted. She's just, it's a nice balance. It's quite cheeky.
I absolutely agree. She's very confident. She's aware that the viewer is watching.
Yeah.
She enjoys it.
That's
and she's
right.
Like inviting him in.
That's right.
She has those beautiful eyelashes.
Yeah.
Like, you know, inviting you. Like,
yeah.
Come see more.
Yeah.
And I also like how you position her, you know, with the feet up.
Yeah.
Reminds me a lot of neoclassical paintings.
Yeah, that's right.
You know?
That has a very, for me, a very spontaneous feel, but then also sort of referencing, if you like, I mean, I love sort of Picasso and that kind of, if you're modern art, sort of classical way of looking at figurative painting.
You can definitely see your vocabulary,
yeah.
Your borrowing elements,
yeah.
That you're making it your own.
Of course, in terms of having that natural, intuitive, spontaneity kind of feel to it. Like I said, I don't always know what I'm going to paint, as it were, but in the spontaneity, there is an awareness in terms of how I'm going to composition the piece, if you will.
I find that very exciting because most artists, they do preparatory sketches,
mm-hmm.
and you just go and attack
mm-hmm.
the canvas.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very refreshing.
Mm-hmm.
Because most artists, they try to be in control,
mm-hmm.
but you're just letting go, you're just playing with the materials,
yeah.
mixing them together,
yeah.
and then at the end, your work looks spontaneous,
mm-hmm.
but it's still very well thought,
mm-hmm.
and you can see that it has been calculated.
Yeah, no, definitely. It's not, what's been really good about this residency as well, at first I was somewhat hesitant going, do I want people to watch me painting, but what's been really good is people have been able to see the process and see that yes, the work has a very, let's say for want of expression, free flow kind of feel, but then it's still very, there is an antenna, you know, going on. The artist does know what he's doing. And even the choice of materials and the texture, they give voice and volume to the piece. So normally some of my pieces, the background is actually quite heavily textured sometimes.
Mm-hmm.
But this, it was important to me to even feel the actual canvas coming through because it has a kind of light feel to it. It's not immediate, it doesn't feel weighted. I mean, and this, it's important to me that the figure of Bernadette, that she is central to the piece, you know, and other elements in the piece complement her story, if you will.
Absolutely great. And I love the little, you know, touches that you have. You have the beautiful detail, just the outline of her body.
Yeah.
And like some pastel, beautiful pink, soft pink.
Yeah.
And a nice warm yellow.
Yeah.
And just like they embrace and they just define her curves.
Yeah. Thank you. I mean, colors are really important to me because you can, without going into too much detail, you know, I always say to someone, if you listen to a piece of music, it takes you back somewhere, you know, like there's references, and I like suggestion, you know, like I say, I come from theatre, my background, as you can see in the space, if you purely just put a chair in the space, you can allow the imagination of the viewer to respond to a piece, and I love inviting people and not patronising the viewer. I love people to come to a piece and to feel involved and to allow, to give them suggestions, but then allow their body to respond and to create a story and a world for themselves.
Absolutely. And with this artist residency, mm-hmm. we try really to give you a platform, mm-hmm. a place that is actually a stage.
Yeah.
Something familiar where you come from theater.
Yeah, definitely.
The movies. So it is a way for you to present your work, mm-hmm. also work, but also keep in mind that, as you said, the viewers, people come in, they just walk in, they're looking above your shoulder.
Yeah.
And we have had some very positive responses.
Thank you.
Because people look at the work without seeing you work on it, mm-hmm. and they have a different reaction to it.
Yeah.
And then once they are here at the gallery and they're looking above your shoulder, they understand that there's a lot of process, mm-hmm. and you also work simultaneously at many, many different paintings.
Yeah. Yes, I do like to work on more than one canvas. For me, it's not only efficient in terms of when paint's dry, and if I have the energy, then I use it to execute another idea that's constantly working in me. But it's fun as well, and if you're very passionate about what you do, then you're productive. And sometimes I might have four canvases out, but the piece that I'm working with may say, you know, stay on the piece, sort of meditate with it, because with the colors that I've layered, an image presents itself to me. But it's also nice because then you can have a, it's nice breathing away time from that piece.
I feel you also like let the works to marinate.
Definitely.
With time.
Definitely.
And then you just work on something new, go back at it.
That's right.
Take a look.
That's right.
Let it breathe.
Yeah.
And then think about it. Mm-hmm. And then you continue.
Definitely. Definitely. It's very important for me to have also a sense of improvisation in the work. So not carelessness, but like you said, allowing something to marinate. So you put an idea down and let the idea breathe. And take a step away, and then you come back and then you assess. So it's not just, let me throw something out and see what happens. It's not, there's an idea, don't disregard the idea, deal with it, come away, and then you come back and assess, and then it presents something else to you.
I also find very interesting that you use acrylics.
Mm-hmm.
So they dry very fast,
yeah.
and you don't mix them.
No.
So they're just pure tissue out of the...
Definitely. Yeah. I do, I love this kind of, sense of, I'm careful not to use the word organic or even the word primitive because that gives a different story, but authenticity, if you will, when I see children draw. You know, a child picks up a crayon or coloring pencil and they just immediately respond to the color, and you tell them, draw a tree, and they immediately respond with that instinct. And there's something really refreshing in that, and I like that kind of way, and I've taken that sense of playfulness into a sense of awareness as an adult of maturity and training, if you will. And with that, like you said, not mixing the colors, and they have for me this real demand when you look at them, because the colors, they don't clash, but there's a juxtaposition that creates another kind of story and another world. People look at the piece and they say, you have a particular world. And it's playful, and it's fun.
We still have a taboo, most artists have a taboo with not mixing colors.
Yeah. And you know, like, oh, it's not gonna work, or it's not very mature, or something like that. But you have to kind of break away from taboos, and you have to develop your own voice.
Yeah, I think it has a lot to do with acceptance.
Right.
As well.
That's true. I think a lot of people want to feel accepted by a particular community, and also be regarded with a narrative that's, you know, happened before them. But I think what makes you exciting as an artist is, I think it's Marcel Duchamp who said that, you know, I don't believe in art, I believe in artists. It's you have to have your own voice.
An artist makes art.
Exactly. And it's if you're constantly true to who you are, then, although it might sound like cliche, but if you're true to who you are, then I think the work, people respond to it, they enjoy it.